In this Relief Maker tutorial, we're going to cover how to import models, how to remove models from the scene, and a few things that you can try if the models don't look the way you think they should. In other words, there's a problem. So the first thing to know is, where do we import a model from? And there's two locations. You can go to the Assets, Add from File, or you can click the plus button at the bottom of the Assets panel. And this is the most efficient, generally speaking. It's what we're going to use for the rest of the tutorials. So we're going to click the plus, and we see the file open box. And it's important to note that depending on your version of Relief Maker, you may have different options. Maybe you only have 3D meshes. But for more advanced users, normal maps and height fields can also provide some interesting effects. But we're going to focus on 3D meshes. So you have access to OBJ and STL. And this will cover just about any model that you're going to find online, or probably that you're going to make yourself. STLs will cover all of the 3D printing libraries and repositories that you might find. And OBJ is going to cover any of the artist grade stuff that you might be looking for. So that being said, let's go ahead and import a model. We're going to select one, and you can only import one at a time. So we'll select elephant. Let's press open. And after just a second or two, the model is shown. Now I'm going to move this over, and we're going to import another model. Add again. And it's important to note here that your version of Relief Maker may not support multiple models. Relief Maker Pro does. So after a few seconds, we see this box. And if you look closely, you'll notice that we've already imported the ant. And it's really small. And that is because that whenever these two things were modeled in whatever software they were made in, this artist decided to make it a certain size, and this artist decided to make this a certain size. That's it. And sometimes that's good. Certainly it's good if it's intentional. So if you've made multiple models at a very specific relative size and you need to make sure that's maintained, you'll want to click ignore here. But for most people, you're going to want to have kind of individual asset control. I want to be able to make this ant bigger, and I want to be able to position it randomly. Maybe so he's riding the tusk and he may be bigger or smaller. In that case, it's better if I can work with the ant more easily. And so I want it to be roughly the same size as the elephant, just for ease of use. And sometimes you may bring in models that are, you know, you won't even be able to see them because they're so big, right? Certainly in those cases, you'll want to do this too. So we're going to click apply to auto resize it. And we see that now the ant is the same kind of relative size as the elephant. And this just makes it a lot easier to interact with. So now I can move him around, maybe make him ride the elephant, and there we go. So just be aware that if you import multiple models, you'll have the option to auto resize, and that's what it does. The next thing we want to learn here is how to remove things. The first thing that we need to do to be able to remove a model is we have to select it. And we can select it in a few ways. On the 3D work area, I can left click and it'll turn blue. And that means it's selected. We see its associated node also becomes selected. I can multi-select in the 3D work area or in the assets panel by holding down control. And we see that multiple things are now selected. Anyway, you can select it from here, or I can just click in this box and it'll also select. And then we're gonna either press delete on the keyboard, or we can click the remove button. So in this tutorial, we've learned how to bring in a model and how to remove a model. Now let's talk really quickly about some ways that you might optimize a model once it's come in. And to do that, I'm gonna remove everything from the scene, and I'm gonna bring in a model I know has problems. We'll open this chemistry set. And when we look at it, let's zoom in a little bit, and we can see that we're getting some weird behavior, right? Whatever modeling application this was made in, maybe it had some weird stuff going on. Meshes you'll find online can have all kinds of problems. One thing you can do to try to fix that inside Relief Maker itself is click Mesh Optimization. When you turn that on, we see that a lot of problems, not everything, but a lot of the problems here have been cleaned up. And we'll probably get a really good relief out of this model now, whereas before, maybe we wouldn't, right? So you can toggle this on and off. Be aware that this is not the end-all be-all of mesh repair, right? It's just something you can try that does a pretty good job in very specific kinds of cases. And that's it. In this tutorial, you have learned how to open models, remove models from the scene, select models, and some basic mesh cleanup should you need it.